Hello guys, today I'm going to tell you about the clavicle or collarbone. The clavicle consists of two faces and two ends, a body. The clavicle extends between the manubrium of sternum and the acromion of the scapula. It's classed as a long bone and can be palpated along its length in thin individuals. It's visible under the skin. The clavicle has three main functions. Attach the upper limb to the trunk as part of the shoulder girdle. Protects the underlying neurovascular structures, supplying the upper limb. Transmits force from the upper limb to the axial scalation. In this video, we shall look at the anatomy of the clavicle, its bony landmarks, and site determination. The clavicle is slender bone with an S shape. Facing forward, the medial aspect is convex and the lateral aspect is concave. It can be divided into a sternal end, a shaft, and an acromial end. The sternal end contains a large facet for articulation with the manubrium of the sternum. At the sternoclavicular joint. The inferior surface, of the sternal end is marked by a rough oval depression for the costoclavicular ligament. And so this is impression for costoclavicular ligament. The shaft of the clavicle acts point of origin and attachment for several muscles, especially inferior surface, such as deltoid, trapezius, subclavius, pectoralis major, sternocleidomastoid, and sternohyoid. Subclavian groove is an elongated groove on the inferior surface at clavicle, which attachment to the subclavius muscle. Acromial end. The acromial end houses a small facet for articulation with the acromion of the scapula. And at the acromioclavicular joint. It also serves as an attachment point for two ligaments. Inferior surface, conoid tubercle, attachment point of the conoid ligament, the medial part of the coracoclavicular ligament. Trapezoid line, attachment point of the trapezoid ligament. The lateral part of the coracoclavicular ligament. The coracoclavicular ligament is a very, very strong structure, effectively suspending the weight of the upper limb from the clavicle. So, how do we know which side this belongs to? Medial end of the bone is thick and rounded, whereas the lateral end is flattened. Superior surface is smooth, whereas the inferior surface is rough on either and due to attachment of ligaments. Medial two-thirds of the shaft is convexity anteriorly, whereas the lateral one-third is concave anteriorly. And finally, when I take the conoid tubercle back, we understand that this bone is a right-sided clavicle. Thank you very much for listening. See you.